The Wolf and the Seven Little Goats. A very loving and clever mama goat lived in a pretty cottage with her seven little kids. One day, she was going to the market, leaving the kids at home. "Don't open the door unless you are sure I have returned. There's a wolf out," she warned them. The big bad wolf watched mama goat going away. He went up to the cottage and knocked at the door. The kids called out, "Who's that?" "Your mama goat, dear," replied the wolf. "Look what I've got for you." The kids whispered among themselves. Then one of them said, "We know you're not mama. Go away, wolf. Mama goat has a very sweet voice." "Your voice is very loud and harsh," said another. The wolf brought a jar of honey and drank all of it. He hoped that his voice would sound better. He went back to the cottage. Going up to the door again, he called the kids sweetly. "I'm back, children. There are lots of goodies for you. Open the door." The excited kids ran up to open the door. But they saw a large paw covered with black fur. This was not Mama Goat. "You are not Mama Goat," they shouted. "You've got large black hairy paws." The wolf went to the bakery. The baker was carrying some flour. He was terrified seeing the wolf and trembled with fear. The wolf rolled his paws in the flour and went back to the cottage. "Open up, kids," called the wolf, and he showed them his paws covered with flour. The poor kids believed the wolf this time and opened the door. When they saw the big bad wolf coming in, they fell back in horror. The goat's kids ran for their lives. One dived under the table and one in the fireplace. One kid crawled under the bed while another ran into the kitchen. One of the kids got into a cupboard and one inside the larder. The last one ran and hid inside the grandfather's old clock. The wolf caught all of them except the one in the clock and swallowed them up. Mama Goat returned in the evening and was surprised to see the door wide open. She ran in and saw that everything in her house lay scattered. Dishes were broken, the chairs tumbled, and the bed was a mess. She began to call her kids and was worried about them. But there was no sign of them. Then a small voice said, "I'm here, Mom." She ran to the clock. Opening it, she found the smallest kid inside it, crying and shaking with fright. He told her all that had happened. She took the little fellow and went out to look for her other children. Mama Goat was searching for the kids when she heard a loud sound. Someone was snoring. She followed the sound and reached the woods on the hillside. There, under a tree, the wolf lay fast asleep, snoring. Mama Goat peered at him from behind the tree and saw he had a huge belly and something was moving inside it. "Those must be my children," Mama Goat decided. "I must get them out." Turning to the little kid, she whispered to him to run back home and fetch her scissors and a needle and thread. The little fellow ran back home and returned quickly. He gave the scissors, the needle, and thread to his mother. She took the scissors and set to work. Mama Goat cut open the stomach of the sleeping wolf. Luckily, all her kids were safe, and they jumped out one after another. She hugged her little ones happily. Mama Goat told each of them to bring the largest stone. The kids ran around and brought her a pile of stones. She had stuffed them all into the wolf's stomach and stitched it up before he woke up. The wolf woke up later, feeling uncomfortable. He was thirsty. He walked to a well nearby, wondering what was rumbling inside him. As he bent over for a drink, he slipped and fell in. And that was the end of the big bad wolf. Thanks for watching. Do like, share, subscribe to Sahil Bookhouse.